So welcome to your 17th Visual Basic tutorial, and in this tutorial I'm going to be teaching you how to build an advanced login system which is going to be based around settings. So if you haven't already watched the previous tutorial, go ahead and watch that now, and then you can come back to this one and you'll be ready to go. So what this login system will let us do is we can have a register form, and we can have like a change username and password form, and we can also store information about the user. I'm going to just make a login form, a register form, and a change password form. But if you want to, you can just play around with it and try and figure out how to do the other things. So what I'm going to do first is I'm just going to increase the width of form one, and then put two labels in. Change the text of the first one to login, and copy it and just paste it and put it over there, and change this one to register and change the text of the form to secure area, and then we want a couple more labels. So again, just paste those in. First one's going to be username. Copy that. And password. So like that. And then we just want two text boxes. And just line them up how you like. So there's our login form. Now we just need to add a button, so like a login button. And then what I'm just going to do is I'm going to copy this and paste it over in the register side and just move it on along a bit. So like that. Move this login button down. And we need to just copy and paste this password box, because this is going to be like the confirm one. So I just do confirm, because we don't really have enough space to fit it all in. And then the button is going to be register. And then one last thing on this form, we just need to select all of the password boxes. So password, password, and confirm. Just select all of those. And we need to set it so that we get those black dots. So do use system password characters, set that to true. And all that will do is it will just give you the black dots so that you can't see the password, just to be a bit more secure. And I'm just going to move that down a bit. So that's like our login form. Doesn't look great, but it will do. It's not really all lined up properly, but it will still work, as long as you've got the controls. So here's text box 1, text box 2, 4, 3, and 5. As you can see, it's got these two the opposite way around. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put these the right way around, so 3 here and 4 there, just so that it doesn't confuse us. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then we've got the two buttons. So now what we need to do is go up to Project and Windows Application 1 Properties, and here we're just going to set a couple of settings. So we're going to add a new field. So the first one's going to be user, second one's going to be pass. So username and password, both of them are going to have the type of string. Scope is going to be user, and we're not going to put a value in. So now we've got our settings ready, we're going to do the login form. So what we've got to do now is just add a new item and Windows form, and just rename this to secure form .vb, and this is the form that will show up once you've logged in successfully. So just go back into form 1 and double click on this button, And here we're going to do a condition, so an if statement. We're going to do if text box 1.text equals my.settings.user and text box 2.text equals my.settings.pass, then, and it should put the end if automatically. So you should know what this means by now. Basically, if the text in text box 1 is the same as the username setting, and text box 2 text is the same as the password setting, then we'll do this, else we'll do this. So if they are the same, then we'll do form, no, we called it secure form dot show me dot hide. And that's pretty much what we've got to do there. So now the else, we're just going to do a message box dot show, put the brackets, and here we're just going to put in capitals wrong username slash password combination. So that's what will happen if it's not correct. So now our login form is all set up. Hopefully there's no errors and it will work smoothly. Now we need to do the register form. So again, text box 3, 4 and 5. So just double click on the register button. And first we need to check that, if I go back a tier, we need to check that this box and this box are the same. Because if they're not, then they've got them wrong. And they need to go and check that they've got the passwords right again. So we're going to do if, and that's text box 4.text equals text box 5.text. Then, so basically, if the text in text box 4 is the same as what's in text box 5, then we're going to go on to do something there. Else, and here we're going to put passwords. Oops, we've got a message box. Message box dot show. And here we're gonna do passwords do not match. So like that. Now we're gonna do what happens if they do get them the same. So here what we're gonna do is my dot settings dot user equals text box 3.text, so the username box, my dot settings dot pass equals, then here we can choose between text box 4 and text box 5 because they both be exactly the same, so it doesn't really matter. So I'm going to do text box 4. And then we just need to save it, so my.settings.save, so like that. And if we run this now, and we try and log in with something like this, log in, wrong username slash password combination, so I'll just clear that. And if I register, so I'm going to do nil. And the password is going to be test. Notice kind of a mistake there. I've set the U, because I dragged these so that this one goes up there and this one goes down there. So I switched them around. This one's got the password characters and this one hasn't. So we need to go and sort that out. So just confirm password. Register. So that's registered. Another thing we need to do is we want to have a message box that pops up saying that your account has been successfully registered. Otherwise they'll sit there and keep pressing this and it will freeze up. So here for the username we did new, and password is test, so login, and we've got the secure form. So what I'm going to do now is under this my.settings.save, I'm just going to quit this. So under my.settings.save, I'm going to do message box dot show. And then Account successfully created. Select that. And I don't need to test that because you know what that's going to do. If you wanted, you could make it so that that secure form would open up once you've registered. But I'm just going to leave it that they've got to log in again. So that's that sorted out. Now you need to go back to this form 1 and sort out this password characters thing. So turn it off for the username and on for the password. So now we're going to set up this change password form. So go to secure form and I'm just going to put some big text there saying you're logged in. So you are logged in. Make the font bigger. Select that. And here I'm just going to put another small label. Change the text of this to change password and put a text box in. So this is where you're going to put the password. And one other thing we actually need to do before this is put old password. And I'm going to put that underneath that one. And switch these text boxes around. So that text box 1 is at the top, just so that we don't get confused. Select these. Change use system password characters to true. And then we just need a button, like a submit button, which will just save the settings. So change this to save. So again, text box 1 and text box 2. So first we need to check that they've put the old password correct. So I put if and text box 1.text equals my.settings.pass. Then we're going to do something there. Else, put the bracket, put message box dot show, put the brackets, and here we're just going to put wrong password. So now we need to set what happens if they get their old password right. We need to do my.settings.pass equals, and then we're going to do text box 2.text. So basically we're just going to change the password setting to the text that's in text box 2, and then we need to do my.settings.save to save it. So now if we run this, it should all be working. So I'm going to log in again. So my username was Neil and the password was test. Log in. You are logged in. Old password. If I put in John or something, just put in something random. John, change password to hello, save, wrong password. I've actually got to change it, put this as test, save. It's given me that wrong password thing, only because I pressed it a couple of times. And the second time I pressed it, the password had changed, so the password would have been wrong. So if I put in hello in here again, save, and it's changed the password. So if I run this again, and I log in, so test, no sorry, Neil, and test, log in, wrong password, and if I put in hello, log in, it's the correct password, and we're logged in. So one more thing, when we press the save button, I want a message box to come up saying that the password has been changed. So stop this, stop the bugging. And we just want to put under my.settings.save message box dot show, and then here we're just gonna put password has been changed like that. So that's your tutorial on how to make a login form using settings. I hope you found this tutorial useful. If you did, don't forget to comment, rate and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.